Hey there, friend. Thanks for checking in. A couple days ago, I watched a video from the Gun Collective. John Patton reviewed the Narrow Arms N1. And he had a couple issues with it. We're going to talk about that today, but here it is. New for 2019, a subcompact 9mm handgun. Carries 7 rounds. It's a single feed into a stagger stack magazine. All right. Short barrel. It does have a double action trigger, aluminum that is red. All right, that's kind of cool. And it's a hammer fire gun. Very thin, very lightweight. When he reviewed the gun, he said a couple things that I agree with, and that has to do with the reset. So we pull the trigger and it has 2 clicks. The first click right there, you heard that. That is a stiff trigger, nothing happened in there. And then there's the actual reset. So it resets at full rest position. And that could be confusing when shooting, and I get that. Another thing that he said was that the N1 shot low for him. All right, I didn't experience that, but I can see why he did. He said that the trigger pinched his finger. I didn't experience that. And he also mentioned that his support hand, when gripping the gun, caused to activate the magazine release and drop the mag. He said that his magazines did not drop free. And you know, this one is, sometimes it does and sometimes it doesn't. It looks like that now it is. All right, so I'm not here to say everything that he said was wrong, but the reason for this video and what I'm trying to accomplish is to see whether this gun can feed, fire, and eject self-defense ammo. He had a problem with that, and I owe it to the viewers of this channel, being that I already reviewed this gun, for them to see whether the Narrow Arms N1 can feed, fire, and eject self-defense ammo. I brought 3 out here. Now, this is LTEC self-defense 124 grain ammo. I used this hollow point there. I used this with the range review for the N1. So I think this is going to work just fine. The other self-defense ammo that I brought out is Remington Golden Saber Black Belt. All right, I pulled it out of my car PM9. All right, I wasn't expecting to do this today, or you know, when you see me at this range, I'm actually quite a bit away from my primary house. So I had this already. So we're gonna see if that Remington Golden Saber Black Belt will work. I'll even pull out the round for 7 rounds. Now the one type that he had was Federal HST. And here it is. I bought it just for this review. This did not work with his model. We're going to see if it does work. No targets or anything. This is just a function kind of thing here. So let's start with the LTEC, and I'm just going to pull the trigger. One of the things that he said was, and I agree with this, that follower, you know, points straight up. So when you load a round, you can see how high it goes. And he said that it's possible that the angle doesn't fit into the chamber as well as it should. So we're going to see right now if it does. You can see that it does. After a few, settle down. I'll go ahead and put my ears and eyes on and make sure that I have 7 loaded up. I'm not going to do any editing here, guys. I think that's 7. It is. All right. So this is LTEC 124 grain self-defense ammunition. All right. So that worked fine. And that time, the magazine, okay, so the magazine dropping is inconsistent. We can see that. Here is the Remington Golden Saber Black Belt. I carry this in my car PM9. I like this ammo. I think it's a smooth shooting ammo with everything that I've tested with it. It's a hot and humid day here, I tell you. All right, so here we go. We're gonna charge it, and that seemed to charge fine. We'll go ahead and fire this. Okay, that was fine and I had no issues. Slide lock back. I did not feel that my finger was pinched and my support hand did not drop the mag. I'm really interested in this though, Federal HST, because he had this round and said that this one created a problem for him. And I want to know for the viewers of this channel, because I reviewed it, but I did not use Federal HST. So now they will be able to see firsthand whether it works or not. All right, that's 7 rounds. Okay, you can see in the witness holes there. And, well, all right, I didn't do a good job with that. Let me do that again. Because this will, this gun will chamber around when slammed home, and that's what happened right there. But I'm going to go ahead and charge it. Okay, now that time it did not work with Federal HST. So I have to say that that part was accurate on his part. Let me try to slam it in here. And that time it did. Let me go ahead and take a few shots. He said halfway through a mag at times that he had jams. Let's see if I do with my N1. All right, that worked. I want to try that one more time. I'm not going to use all these. How about 4 rounds? Okay, these are the Federal HST. We'll go ahead and throw that mag in there, charge the gun. That time it did work, 4 rounds. And I did have a jam and the magazine did release. So what I'm learning here, guys, is that every gun, it's really not what I'm learning, but what I'm hoping to demonstrate is that every gun is a little bit different. I'm not making excuses for the N1, but if you decide to go with this gun, avoid Federal HST. I saw the Remington Golden Saber Black Belts worked fine, and so did this LTEC, and then we'll see what else we can come up with in the future. But the HST, it fired okay, but it did have a little bit of trouble chambering that first round. I hope this was helpful. I hope the viewers of this channel will take that into consideration if they decide to pick up a Narrow Arms N1. If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.